Hi, it's Kari. Welcome to my studio, and today I'm working with Heirloom Traditions. And I'm kind of excited to start this project, so I'm doing this little bench. It's cute as it is, but not the cute color. So this color is called Irish Cream, and then my thought is I'm going to paint it with the Irish Cream, just a nice smooth coat, and then this is their Venetian texturing medium. And what that does is it thickens this paint. So I'm going to mix a little bit of this paint with this medium inside of here and make a thicker paint. And then I'll probably put that on with a light spatula so I get this texture. And then when I'm done with that second coat, I'm going to use this dark umber traditional, they call it their Heirloom Traditions wax. It's a liquid wax. You don't have to buff it or anything. You just apply it with a rag. So these are all kind of new. So that's what we're going to do. So first, when you get your paint, again, this is Irish Cream. You just want to shake it up real well. You're always welcome to add a pinch of water to your paints when you're working with Heirloom Traditions paints here. So you can always add a little bit of water if you like. It comes in this nice, easy, open jar. I always kind of start with the lid. I'm a little bit of a messy painter. And then you want to get yourself one of these nice brushes. They're really nice and they hold the paint well, and they're nice and soft, and you can wash them and reuse them all the time. So I'm going to start off with using the paint from the lid because that's how I work. Generally, I always like to turn my piece upside down. I've got lots of sores and dents and bruises in this little thing, but that's what gives them the charm. So I'm just going to go ahead and add this color. I don't feel like I need to add any water at all. It's just gliding on so nicely. And then I know when I put the thickening agent, the Venetian thickening agent, inside the paint, I can create this other texture that'll make it look, a little bit older than it already is. I could probably use some glue to hold some of these legs together a little, but we're going to work with them as it is right now. So I want to get a coat. I might as well just clean this up a little bit too, since it's upside down. It looks like it was yellow once and then green, white originally. So it's already been through a few little lives. So we're just going to give it one more freshen up. So when I paint my pieces, I'm kind of always moving my brush all around. I'm not looking, since this is the style I want to create is a distressed style, I'm not looking to paint in a perfect fashion. So you don't have to worry about your brush marks or anything like that for this situation. There's all different ways of using your paints, but just remember it's your vision that you're trying to create, not necessarily always just getting a color change. You know, you want it to look a little older and peely. So that's what we're going to kind of create today. But I'm really liking the way this color goes on, and I'm actually enjoying it. I touch a lot of paint. I've been painting for 23 years. So when I find something, I kind of know when I like it, and I'm thinking I really like this. So I say you should try some of it out yourself too. I will give a little discount away. Get a little discount if you order through my code of KCD, but we'll put a link in so you can receive your discount. So you can try it for the first time and get a little discount while you're doing it. That's always good. We like discounts. Sometimes we don't know why we should try a new paint, but if they're going to offer a discount, why not, right? So this is Irish Cream, is the color. And it's a chalk-like paint, and I'm really liking it. I'm just putting it on. I use my brush, like I'm not even really holding it like a real painter brush. I'm just kind of smacking my piece around. Because remember, I'm gonna do that second coat where I thicken the paint, and where actually all the action's gonna happen is probably on the top. But I am gonna get it, you know, so it looks layered. So maybe it was painted quite a few times over the years. So that's when I'm doing things, I just have to tell myself little stories. Like, oh yeah, it was at grandma's house and then it got passed down. And that's why you don't want to, you know, necessarily take away all your little chips. Because, you know, I have some cute little chips here. I might want to leave some of those. So that's why I always paint with a lighter hand. and a heavier hand, I can always add paint. It's easy to add, and it's not always easy to take off. You know, if you want to sand it and do all that, that's kind of hard work. So on the top, I'm going to make a decision, because remember, I already know in my mind I'm doing a second coat, so I may not want to fill it all in on my first coat. So I'm going to give myself a little bit of breath there. And breath, I mean just a little bit of room, so when I come in for the second coat, I can make up some more texture. You know, I just don't want this to look from painted from green to Irish cream. I want to make it look like it has been used and loved. And so I need to create some texture. It's drying pretty quickly. I do have my windows open, so I'm getting a pretty fast dry. So it looks like I'm gonna probably be able to mix my paint and go on to my second coat fairly quickly. Okay, so cuteness already happening with Irish cream on there. And then what I'm gonna do, it has a formula for how much, this is the Venetian thickening paste. I barely used any paint. So I'm just gonna wing this, you guys. This is how you kind of have to do. So I'm just gonna pour like a splash of this stuff out. The Irish cream, like that's probably like 2 tablespoons. I want it thick. So then I'm gonna add, so I think it said to add like 4 tablespoons for 16 ounces of the thickening agent, which is this powder. So I'm gonna add this powder to my paint, and then it thickens, oh yep, it thickens it right up. Look at that, isn't that cool? It fluffs it all up, and it makes it kind of gritty, it looks like. That's kind of cool. It just swelled up a little. So I'm gonna do one more little splash because I want it really thick. And then I'm gonna excuse myself from the camera while I forgot to get my little trowel. I'm gonna get a little trowel for this. I have these little spatulas that I find online, and that's what I'm going to use to now put my second coat of thick paint. I use the Venetian thickening agent. This is a thick texture medium, and I mixed it in with the Irish cream, and I put the first coat on with the brush, and then I'm going to age it with their wax. But I thickened up this paint, so now look at that. It's nice and thick. And so what I'm going to come to do now is I'm going to come up to the top of my piece, and I've put some on my trowel, and I'm going to pull this down. Oh, look at how cool that is, you guys. Isn't that cool? I don't know, just fun stuff like that. It's fun. So this is what the thickening agent does. And I'm just going to put it on as if, I don't know, they used it for milking and now they've stepped on it. I didn't make a lot because I can always make more, because it's just a little tiny little piece. So that is how the thickening agent goes on, thickening medium. But I'm going to do it some other places too. So logically, where it probably would happen would be like on this little area here. I can put some paste, and then I can kind of smash it around my little legs. I'm digging this. So if you want to do something bigger, you should leave some comments, email me, and tell me more of how you would like to see me use Heirloom Traditions paint, because right now I'm thinking this is pretty darn cool. And remember, I'm gonna have one more effect on here that's gonna kind of come in and even add some more age to this piece. I see a pinch of my green on here, which I want to, because that gives me layers and history. And you guys, I just kind of flicking it around, and I'm not overthinking anything. I'm not really trying too hard. I'm gonna see what happens if I want to put it on with a little bit with the brush. Yeah, that's cool too. I wouldn't put it all on with the brush for me, because I like what the trowel does. but you can just kind of do some smashing around. This thickening medium is pretty darn cool. And so I'm going to slap it on a little bit on the back. You can use a credit card, an old credit card. You can use the same thing for as your little trowel. And it just, this is almost exactly the size of a credit card. I just have a little bit of a handle. They are a little bit difficult to find, these little spatulas, but so worth it. And then after it's dried up on the top a little bit, I'm just kind of pulling it a little to get myself that extra crunch. And then I think, you know, you kind of got to sit back, you know, and say, okay, is that enough? Do I want more? But I have all kinds of ideas now for this stuff. I really like the way this thickening medium, texture medium, just instantly made it thick. And so I think it's just brilliant. I'm loving Heirloom Tradition. So I'll give you my code, and then you go out there and you get on their website and you get some for you, and then you post it on my Facebook page too. Tell me what you did with it. Love to see your project. Tell me how you work it. You guys, you can change colors too. You can have multiple colors going on there too. So now I do have to let that dry up, and we'll come back and I'll paint it one more time. Okay, that texture medium stuff dried really nicely. I went ahead and let it dry overnight, and now I'm going to put on the liquid wax. It comes in 12 different colors. It's not heat sensitive. You don't have to buff it. You just apply it, and it clear coats it and gives it an aging effect already. So today I'm using the dark umber, and for my sake for now, I'm just going to put a little bit in this. I haven't opened it yet, so I have a feeling there's a little tab I need to get off right there. So let's pull the tab off. Sometimes I just have to poke it with my brush. And then I'm just going to squirt a little bit out in this little container. I'm going to start a little. So it's pretty watery. That's kind of cool. And I start with a little because, you know, like I said, I can always, I don't know how dark I want it and how dark it's going to go. So I just start with little bits, and then I decide if I want it darker or lighter. So I always like to offload my brush onto something before I just start slapping dark wax on it, because you know, you might not want it that dark. So, but I think I'm liking it, and then I'm gonna see what happens when I do the top. But yeah, I'm liking it. It's a pretty color. It's not too dark, and it's getting, oh yeah, you guys, I'm finding some fun treats here. I don't know if they show up on camera so well, but what I'm seeing is the way that when the texture medium is in the paint, how it reacts differently with the wax. So we're on a very small piece. So this is some stuff that you really want to kind of play with a little bit more. I want to play with it a little bit more, the texture medium, and maybe doing multiple colors and things. So if you're enjoying this video and you receive your discount and you get some good products, just, you know, go over to my Facebook page, talk to me, tell me what else you would like me to show you about with Heirloom's Traditions paint, because I paint all the time. So I just need a little bit of encouragement on what y'all want to do, because, you know, sometimes it's just I'm not thinking the way you're thinking and you wish something was happening. I'm just going to get a paper towel real quick.
Excuse me.
It seems to absorb in and then fade back. So it's not really grabbing really strongly like I'm used to when I'm working with dark waxes or stains. So I'm finding this pretty interesting. I'm enjoying it while I'm sharing this with you guys. To me, just seeing the little magics happen right in front of your eyes is always what keeps me painting more. Like, how can I push it a little? But this is already giving me such an old look for very little effort. Really little effort at all in my mind. And it's turning out very, very cute. So let's get to something kind of fun and big like the top, okay? I'm going to put a little bit more, and I'm going to come in and age it. But see, my texture medium shows up really nicely in here and separates itself. And so it, when you put it on, it's always going to kind of be a little, I mean, from my experience from painting so long, it kind of gets a little embedded into the paint, and then the paint color shows up. I'm just going to smash it with my little paper towel because I can. I just want to see what happens and see how all that cool effect is coming on. So at the end of the day, this isn't really going to be a white stool. It's going to be a dirty Irish cream. So that's the color we used. Originally it was the green, and then we put the Irish cream, and then we added the texture medium to the Irish cream paint, and we let it dry. Remember, we put that on with a little trowel and the brush, and it was pretty easy. So, you know, you don't even technically have to wax the whole thing, because look at what's happening there. To me, that is magic that is just given to you. Like, it's just, you just take it. You take that magic when it shows up like that. That looks very old and how did I do it kind of look, you know? So I'm just going to keep going around and use my, this is my umber. What are we using? This is the dark umber. I don't know. The dark umber liquid wax. 12 different colors this liquid wax comes in. So there's plenty of things to choose from. You don't have to have everything aged brown. I'm going to add a little bit more. I'm not going through too much. You know, it goes on and it just soaks up, and then it makes itself a little translucent. I get kind of a little bit of a sheen, and I don't even have to buff. I just put it on with this wax. I mean, with this brush, and it's not heat sensitive. So with that, I'm imagining it can be, you know, at a nice window that gets a lot of sun, and the quote unquote wax won't melt. So that's good. I am really liking this. So when I play with little things like this, then it gives me good ideas for bigger pieces, you know, to do some good distressing on. This technique just right here would make a really nice kitchen island, you know, and with 12 different colored waxes, certainly you could come up with a paint and wax combination that you liked. I think it'd be really fun, because I really enjoy that. I'm really enjoying the texture of the texture medium, as well as how it's reacting with the wax and giving me a separate look as to where I just painted it. So I'm giving everything a 10, and because I'm giving it all a 10, I'm giving you a discount code too. All right, so it's KCD at Heirloom's Tradition. We're using the umber wax, the texture medium, the Irish cream paint, and you got yourself a smoking look. I'm pretty excited. So everything feels like it's drying up pretty good, but I do have a nice cross breeze in my studio, so that's helpful. But nothing smells, so it's very low VOC. I like to work a little low VOC. You know, some waxes are really strong. This is nothing. Can't even, it smells like air. Fresh air. Fresh air in San Diego. That's where we are. We're in San Diego. All right. So, I think I just created a very cute finish. Well, not cute. Cool. Distressed. Interesting. Way more history than when I showed up to it just solid green. There's just a few little areas I'm gonna wipe real quick that I just got too much on. That's applicator air. That's me. I did that. Put too much on. So it's drying up pretty well. I like it because it has a fairly matte sheen to it. You know, it has a clean feeling about it, but a distressed look. Does that make sense? It doesn't feel too matte, like it's dry and dirty. So I am enjoying it. All right. I just love how the milkiness, the way the wax didn't accept all the way in. It does accept all the way in, but how it's reacting to it, and so I get this unique look. So really, honestly, you guys, that is the bomb. So we use the Heirloom Traditions Irish Cream Paint. First coat just painted on. Second coat, we added the texture medium to it. And I did that by eye because I knew I didn't need a lot. It has directions if you want to mix up like 16 ounces, you put like 4 tablespoons in. And then I let it dry for 24 hours and then went right over it with the liquid dark umber wax that comes in 12 colors. And many colors to choose from here too. So try out a set and I'm going to give you my discount code. And I'd love to see what you do with it and post something on my page. All right, thanks.